today, activists are taking part in the first national gay blood drive in an effort to fight the Food and Drug Administration's ban on blood donations from gay and bisexual men. Several turned out in New Orleans saying the ban is outdated. My story, all new at 6.
I was one day told that I was no longer able to donate blood.
For the several protesters who peacefully demonstrated in front of the New Orleans Blood Center, this is the issue at hand.
Men who have had sex with other men since 1977.
Cannot donate.
They cannot donate.
And why?
Under current FDA guidelines, they are not eligible to donate due to the high risk factor of possibly having HIV.
But many here say the FDA's ban is outrageous.
You have a population of people that would love to help other people and that, you know, do it on a daily basis, but they're not able to. You know, there's a lot of reasons out there that people need blood, gay, straight, whatever the case may be. And if we're willing to do that, it's frustrating to not be able to.
Unless I'm dishonest about who I am, then I can't get blood.
Dr. Jonathan Richards is just one who was turned away when he honestly filled out the donor questionnaire, specifically question number 24, asking male donors, have you had sexual contact with another male even once?
The blood is tested regardless of the person who donates it, and the person who donating it, it really shouldn't matter how they identify in terms of their sexuality or whether or not they've had sex with another man.
Dr. Mike Allendary of Tulane University says the policy is archaic and discriminatory, saying medicine has developed leaps and bounds since the 1983 ban was put into place. Back then, no one knew how the deadly virus that causes AIDS spread.
I think the ban should have been put to rest many years ago because our technology with respect for screening blood has improved significantly.
The blood center understands the frustration but says they are just following the federal guidelines.
We just have to work with the FDA and what they can medically prove and decide on.
A 2010 study by the Williams Institute at UCLA estimated that if gay men were allowed to donate, an additional 219,000 pints of blood would be available in the U.S. According to the latest numbers from the CDC, the risk of getting HIV through a blood transfusion is 1 in 1.5 million.